Hey YouTube, Dailyshoefrenzy here, bringing you Jordan 1 High Reimagine size 12 and a half. This is the left shoe. First look at it, as for me, because if you watch any of my prior videos, you'll see I don't open up the shoe, what a box. Actually, I open up the box to see what it is. I came in, checked my tracking to make sure it is what it is. Got these in, I want to say last week, or probably the week before that. Left shoe, suede is smooth on this. Internet chatter, sales aren't what it's supposed to be for a lot of the resellers, people that are still reselling. They're not, it's in the toilet. These are definitely going to stadium good. They just looked on Alias. Highest bid is $93. Last sale, I want to say, is $185. These were 180 from sneakers. No, I got these on the prior release. So on the early release. So I didn't even check Alias. I think I had in my mind that these were definitely going to stadium good. Once again, as I say in every video, at the moment, sneaker market's in the toilet. So it is what it is. I'm going to keep on buying on stuff that I think is going to resell. The only sad part is you gotta hold for a while. So let's see if I fix my focus here. Looked a little out of focus. But yeah, this is the left shoe. Suede materials, man, it looks good. Let me lower that camera a little bit. Yeah. No imperfections. I know Nike's been slipping on that. I mean, there's a viral video of a dunk missing a check. I think it's on the right shoe. Missing a whole check on the side, a whole swoosh, which is wild. Actually, for that person, it might sell for more. It's an imperfection and more than likely a 101. So, could be some money made there. But this is the left shoe, and like I said, suede is on point with it. So, I don't see no issues with this one, actually, anyway. This is the left shoe, size 12 and a half, Jordan Reimagined. I was reading some stuff online or seeing, you know, on sneaker Twitter, if you will. This is the right shoe. Where was I going with that? As far as the releases of Jordan 1s throughout the year, I think they are going to have 14 releases for Jordan 1s this month, or 11. If that number holds true, people are more in depth on what Nike's releasing. I don't get too tied up into that. I see what's coming out ahead of time. Usually look at if I think something's going to sell, I'll try to get it. I mean, I do miss a lot of sneakers being at work when stuff released at 10 o'clock. So try to remember, set my Nike thing. I should probably actually set a reminder, but I don't. Usually my phone's going off crazy at work anyway with the releases. So I try to catch them if I could. But overall, sneaker looks good. No issues, no imperfections, smooth suede shoe, but Jordan 1's getting stale. So they got to come up with something creative. They've flooded the market with dunks. Obviously, Jordan 1's and the colorways, and they could have done something different with it here. Oh, there is extra lace. I checked the other one. Extra lace, extra laces, blue one. Black comes with it. I actually like this blue. I actually might work out. That might actually work out well for somebody that's interested in wearing these. So you never know. Somebody willing to buy these. People that aren't too in tuned into market. I responded to a tweet. Don't remember the young man's name or the Twitter handle, but whether these are gonna go, I think his post was 120 over or under. And I put over. Supposedly it's 400,000 pairs still sitting. But to the average consumer who doesn't get tied up in a Nike stock and reps releasing and all that, a young man or woman that's interested in the shoe or a parent out there that's got some dollars is just going to buy the shoe. Nobody's getting tied up into that because you still have markets where people will just buy no matter what if the sneaker's available. So people shop off of certain websites. That's what they prefer. Different biases to the website that they like buying shoe from. So what's out there for stock is irrelevant. If for somebody that's not in the game like that. So that's just what it is. If you shop at a certain store, you're just going to shop at that store, no matter what. The price may be cheaper somewhere else. Some people shop around. Some people just don't do that. So I think it's going to go higher. Obviously, the 120. Like I said, I paid 180. I'm probably going to take a loss on these as long as it's not too heavy on these. But we'll hold and see. Q4 is usually good for me as far as sneaker reselling. So they're going to stadium goods. I got the Cherry 11s in. I think those are 210 after everything. It's like 220, 225, I think, all said and done with those. What else did I send out? I sent out the Satin Bread, shipped those out to Stadium Goods, so those are on the way there. The vintage Lowe's, black and whites, I call those guys sent out. And the Field 12s, the 11s, the Field Jordan 11s, when I feel purple. That went out to Stadium Goods. So I got the Cherry 11s downstairs. I'll shoot that video next. Today's Sunday. Today's date. November, we'll say December 4th. November 4th. So football Sunday, actually. At 1:22, I'm shooting it. So my mind's all over the place. Losing a little money on the gambling. Didn't look well. Didn't go well this morning for the Dolphins. But I had some money on it. So lost that. Hopefully I pick up with the rest of my parlay. So I've been gym a little bit of everything. But yeah. What else did I sell? I sold the Mamba Rage. Sold those for $560. I bought those for $463. Did I sell for $560? Whatever. I looked at the profit number. It was like $83 made. I lost money on the Tiana Taylor sneakers. Those sold for $218. I paid $243 for those. So I lost about $30 on that one. So, I mean, win some, you lose some. The goal is to make money on all, but if not, on the majority of them. So, yeah. And I got, like I said, those Satin Breads, Vintage, Lowe's, and Field Purple headed out to Stadium Goods. So I shipped those out yesterday. So those should get to them probably Tuesday or Wednesday. We're coming into the holiday season, so shipment as far as receiving and sending stuff out is going to be a little tricky. But, yeah. What else did I miss? I missed on the Dunklows last week. The one that's missing the check. I don't even know the name of them. And I missed out on another Dunklow that I wanted, obviously for resale. But I don't think there's anything hot coming out this week. I'll have to check on Instagram and Twitter while everybody else posts their stuff. You know, follow a couple sneaker guys that post the releases and what's coming out and everything else like that. So next video will be the Cherry 11s coming out that are ready to receive. I'll shoot that video. Resell on those are... 2, I think highest bid is like, I want to say 215, but the last sale was like 280, I believe it was today actually, but those are going to Stadium Goods too, so I'll see what else I could get to send those out with those to Stadium Goods, because I don't like sending two sneakers in the big old box that I have. I had some boxes I got from Home Depot, I use it as sneaker boxes. I could fit upwards, let's say the most I packed in there, depending on size, obviously. I could fit 4 or 5 pairs in a box. Cost more to ship, obviously. Stadium Goods, I believe, went up on their shipping. There's a 3 that I sent out, cost me $18. They charged me $18 to ship those out. So I kind of, oops, hit the camera. I kind of incorporate those into the, not kind of, I do incorporate those into the pricing of the shoes. So it is what it is on that. You know, UPS is going up on their prices, so they got to pay, charge you if they're going up per hour with their employees. So somebody's got to eat the cost of that. So it's going to be the consumer. But that's all right. It's neither here nor there. I'll shoot that video on the next sneakers. Until then, on to the next one.